Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. In this video, we will make some interior design with the modern Thai Japanese living room. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will add a cube in our scene, and after that, we will make it a room. You can scale it and choose front face X to delete. After you set up your camera angle, you can choose your camera from the right menu. You can set up your focal length. Choose your cube again. In tap to edit mode, you can add extra loop cuts with Ctrl R. And E to extrude this face for the making window part. Go to shading tab, under the world setting. You can add a sky texture in here. After you set it up, you can delete this window face. Set up your sun rotation and sun elevation from this sky texture's value. If you want, you can add some air and ozone values with increasing them, giving a more natural daylight. Now, let's make some code. For this, you can add a cube to your scene and after that scale it. We will make it L-type. In edit mode, you can add some extra loop cut with Ctrl R and E to extrude some faces and add subdivision surface modifier with level viewport 1 or 2. After that, in a tab to edit mode again, add extra loop cuts for giving a bit of smooth shape for this. And now, for this coach bottom part, you can shift it to duplicate it and move it to Z axis. Now, let's make a coffee table onto our room. For this, we will add a cube again. You can add extra loop cuts with Ctrl R. For the bottom face, you can E to extrude it down and E to extrude right click as to scale. For the bottom face, you can insert it with I and place your coffee table middle of your room. Choose this coffee table's corners and Ctrl B to bevel them. Shade smooth and don't forget to check your auto smooth. For the back part of our sofa, you can choose these back faces together and E to extrude them up. Give a shape with adding extra loop cuts. For the couch pillow, you can add a cube again. In tap to edit mode, add extra loop cuts. Make it higher and add a cloth dynamic to this cube. Under the pressure, set your pressure value to set up your gravity 0. When you press space, it will affect this cube. You can get some view from your keyframe, which shape you liked. You can choose this. Shade smooth and apply your cloth modifier. You can make a pillow for yourself like this with the Ctrl 1. You can give some subdivision surface modifier it too. Shift E to duplicate and place onto your sofa. Which shape you want, which type you want, you can set your pillow for your interior design. Now, with the front view, you can shift E to duplicate these pillows for the back part of them. Rotate a bit and place. Shift E to duplicate. Rotate in Z axis too for making other part of your couch pillow. If you want to make some more fluffy pillow, you can add a cube again. Don't scale too much. As the same method, add extra subdivision. Set your pressure to and set your gravity 0 again. Get a keyframe for yourself for the shape. Shade smooth and add subdivision surface modifier it too. Now, we will add a plane because we want to make some wooden separator parts to our room. You can scale this plane for giving some thickness. E to extrude this front face. We will cover up to our all of scene with this separator wooden panels. You can shift E to duplicate them and place where you want. For the ceiling or making some curtain maybe with this. For the sailing part, you can shift it to duplicate it again as the same method. We are making this very simple, quick and easy tutorial for making some interior projects. You can add extra details how you want to make. Or to make some wooden console for the left part, or maybe you can make some bookshelf. I to insert this front face and E to extrude in x-axis. From the bottom face, you can shift E to duplicate it and E to extrude them down. You can make some shells like this. Let's make some ways. We will add a circle. After that, you can go check or deselect, scale of your vertices, select all with A and E to extrude them up, rotate in Z-axis a bit, continue to E to extrude it, and give a shape how you want, like a star or flower. You can give some shade smooth, and Ctrl 1 to give some subdivision surface modifier. You can use this type of ways or plates for making some decorative objects. For the making some coffee cups, you can add a circle again. Add a solidify modifier and give some thickness for this. You can scale and add extra loop cuts maybe. Give a round shape for this. For the making holder, you can choose an edge from side, shift E to duplicate it, and press P for separate it. In edit mode for this edge, you can E to extrude it and give a holder shape. Rotate and tidy up some of the edges. You can shift E to duplicate it and put onto your coffee table. Let's make some Japanese type of the lamps. For this, you can add UV sphere and set your segment 16. Scale a bit. For the top face, you can P selection. We will give some holder parts to this lamp. You can delete these top faces and E to extrude them up. If it's too thick for you, choose your faces with Alt and you can give some scale with Alt S. For the top, how you want, you can give some shape for this. And place where you want. We will give some wicker material to this and it will be good look. From the Polyhaven, you can download some decorative objects and use this. I downloaded this marble bust, potted plant, book encyclopedias and standing pictures. We will use this. But before all of this, from the SketchUp add-on, you can go from the top right card. I'll show before how to use and download it. I will download this carpet model. Thanks for the owner. I will use this. After you import your model, you can scale and place middle of your living room. For the making some bookshelf parts, you can choose your wooden panel, scale and place it. You can shift it to duplicate it. For adding our book encyclopedias, you can go to File, Append, find your downloaded Blender project. After that, choose Collection and choose this book encyclopedias. And Ctrl G to join them all together. Scale and place it where you want. For the others, we will make same thing. With the Append, you can choose your Blend file, and after that choose your collection and place onto your living room where you want. From the Blender kit, you can download this freely from their website. I will get some wicker material from here for my Japanese type of the lamp. I will use this, and for the holder part, you can add some metal black material. For the walls, you can search as a plaster or wall material. You can drag and drop it to your scene and it will give materials effect like this. For the floor, if you want, you can add another plane in here and find some wood material. You can drag and drop your materials onto your objects. For the setting up all of your material, choose all of them, last selection material with one and Ctrl L link materials. For the others, I am making same thing. I am searching some materials, drag and drop onto them. For the ceramic material, I am adding something to my coffee cups. If you want, you can add extra objects to your living room, like painting. I downloaded abstract painting. For the window, you can add an extra plane in here and type glass. From this architectural glass, drag and drop. For the plants, you can download all of your things from the Blender kit. With the free objects, you can use this and download from their website freely. As you see, there is a light leaking in here. Choose your cube as your living room and add a solidifier modifier. After you add this, as you see, not leaking anymore. And now I am adding some low poly forest for my outside view. When you get some render with 2K or 4K, you can make your living room or interior architectural visualization projects like this. This is really easy. You can use which type or which room you want, place it. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.